Oh yeah, what is that worried about?
Damn, I'm on a roll.
Good enough. It's 10 to 7 in the morning. Feels like it's 30 degrees. It probably is 30 degrees in the shade. It is so hot. Man, I think it's going to be the hottest day of the year. I'm just organizing my gear. I got lots of water and Gatorade. And I got sports tape this time. Never used it before, so we'll see what that's like. So I'm just kind of organizing my stuff. Probably hour or less, sun's gonna come up. And all these trees are going that way, so I'm gonna be in the sun all day. It's gonna be brutal. Yeah, but I got some nice big firs here. So look at those two big firs out there. And a couple more big ones over there. Yeah, it's gonna be fun today. Good cut today. Okay, here we go. She's a nice big one. It's got a nice lean leading that way. I won't have to wedge it, so that's nice. As long as I get my undercut big enough. And I'm gonna put it, see, I'm gonna swing it just past these branches. And I wanna get it right on that little snag right there, a little short stubby snag. Drop it right on there, or maybe just right there in that spot. And hopefully the butt doesn't slide off down over this bluff right here. It drops off a good 40, 50 feet. Not 40 feet. So, we'll see. Yeah, I'm cooking. And I'm in the shade. Need a nice breeze here. If it's gonna be sunny, at least have a nice breeze, cools down. Okay, you can see my bottom cut, I'm a little far, but just in the middle there, so. I'll double check my aim, but I think it's good.
Ah.
Looks like I am gonna have to wedge it. Oh well. Oh man. Well, I'm gonna cheat a little bit. Just a little bit and cut the middle out from the front. Okay. That's right, cut up. I'm gonna cut any more. Okay, get a spare wedge out of my bag. Okay, got a nice brand new one here.
man. Yes. Yes. Make a progress. Oh yeah.
Yeah, kind of hit like right there, and then rolled down against that little sapling there. Oh no, rolled against that other log I fell the end of yesterday. And most of it stayed, all of it stayed on the bluff, so it's great. Oh, I could have cut some more up on this side. Got a big step though. Take this off the tripod. See how old this tree is. I was just counting the rings after. Just stop the camera and count them. Just kind of maybe just average it out a bit from where I can count the rings. Like right at the end, the last 100 years. The rings get really tight. Really tight. Like, look at that. On that side. A half an inch is like 20 years. Average is 49 inches diameter. Hello, Mike. Hello, Mike. Hey, did you get an answer from Ralph about the oversized fir, what they want to do? For, yeah, because this is bigger than a 6'3", 4'5'1", or 5'5". Do you want me to make a 6'3" for a ripper? Okay. Looks like I need you a 6'3" and they'll rip it. Thank you.
Ah.
Here's my next one. Like a 2.5 foot fur. The issue with this one is it's got a heavy uphill lean. So I'm gonna have to swing this downhill to dodge that tree. It's got a broken top too, eh? Look at that. You see it's leaning pretty good that way too. But it's also leaning pretty heavy up the hill. So if I want it to go right into there, I'm actually gonna have to aim it right there. Because once the holding wood breaks, it's gonna wanna fall uphill. So this will be a little tricky, but I think it'll be okay. We'll see. Oh yeah, perfect. Yeah, I left a bunch of holding wood on the low side just to make sure it didn't go too high. Yeah, looks like it's easy to buck. Right on. Oh, looks like that's the last of my shade. Here comes the sun. Just peeking over the hill now. Yeah. Okay, so I'm just bucking this log here. I took a 12.5 off the top, or the butt log, and then the rest will fly. And so I'm just laming the top in, and check this out. Jackpot. Look at that. For a bird's eye that goes all the way around the tree. That is an expensive piece of burl right there. Wow, it's huge. Look at my foot for scale. Man, that's rare to come across something like that. Fairly rare. That is a huge burl. It's too heavy for me to pack up and pad. And too far. Like, holy smokes. That is so cool. I guess some guy at the sort will grab this. Yeah. Oh, I'm leaving it on here. I'm gonna buck it off up there. Man, that's awesome. Yeah, I figured I'd go check out this creek that I heard just in the region here. That's cool. to worry about bringing water to work anymore. It's nice. It's real cool looking. Oh yeah. It was way up there. Yeah, it just keeps going on down the mountain. This boulder all by itself sitting here. Yeah, quick drink and back to work.
Earmuff. It's good. It's cold. Even the air is cold down here. Oh yeah. Oh, it's cold. All right. Whew. Perks about working out in the bush. Nice, cool. Mountain water.
Okay. This is the one with that broken top. And looks like it's kind of slightly in that way, which is good because I'm going to put it right in there too. Probably right below that short stubby snag right there.
Come on. Come on. There we go. There we go. I think I got to fix my aim. I went too far, I think, on the lower side. Yeah, gotcha, thank you. Maybe not, let's see. Oh, looks good. Looks good. My cuts didn't quite line up. Show you. I don't know if you can see anything. See, it didn't quite line out there. The bottom cut went a little bit far. Just a little bit. You know what? I wonder if I should make the undercut bigger. I'm gonna do it, I'm gonna make it bigger. Okay, I turn the camera off and fix it. Okay, so I'm thinking I might need to wedge this one. Made the undercut a little bit bigger, but we'll see. I think I have to wedge it though. I didn't have to wedge it.
Didn't quite lay out how I like it. Oh yeah, look at that. It's a nice big undercut. Yeah. That worked out great. See, if I put it to the left side of that, it's growing right on a rock. See a big boulder there? I don't want to smash it on that and smash all the pieces. So put it right down in there, but then it rolled. I don't know if it's going to be safe to buck. Maybe the first log. Because it drops off just over there. Yeah, we'll see.
wild blackberries. Not quite ripe yet. I bet they'll be tasty though when they are ripe. I'll be long gone by the time they're ripe though. So shouldn't take too long to finish this section of the block. Okay, so here's another pretty good sized fir. I don't know, close to 4 feet. And it's got a pretty good lean to the left. Nice high grade piece of wood. The only concern is there's a draw here. Like, you see this, I'm going down, so like from here, it dips down and then it comes up over there. So I'm kind of worried that this might break in the middle and slab up all the way up the tree. It won't be a clean break, so I'm kind of worried about, but I can't throw it down any lower because it's gonna go down over that bluff over there. And I can't throw it up any higher because those trees are in the way and those trees are coming back this way. So I'm just gonna have to make do with what I got. Perfect. Okay. brushed that one tree pretty good. It's not intentional, but oh well. It's nice looking stuff. Oh yeah, what was I worried about? No problem, saved right out. Guess when you get a tree that big and that solid, it takes a lot more to break it. Look at that. Wow. Now that's a high grade piece of wood. See, when they're really little, they always got bigger rings. This might be like, it'd probably be 100 right here. And then it gets really tight, really, really tight. It's probably 500 years old. This tree, yeah, real tight rings on it. Nice high grade piece. This is worth a lot of money, this tree. Yeah, that's why it pays to take the time, an extra minute or two, or a couple minutes, whatever, to make sure your aim is right, you thought it through, you save up the piece of wood, because it's worth a lot of money. Yeah, that's gonna be easy to buck now. Well, that was fun. I gotta fuel up again now. That rolled way down the hill. Rolled way down there. Hit those saplings down there. This one here, I'll have to probably take one more log off it because it's a hemlock, so it's heavier than fir, so I don't think this will fly full length. I'll measure it and check my weight card.
Okay, so I determined that it's not safe to buck. There's a fir that I have to stand on. It is also suspended up in the air. Yeah, and then the hemlock is sitting on the fir on this end. So if I drop the hemlock, it might shake the fir, which I'm standing on, and I'm up like 10 feet in the air or more. Not worth it. I could rig and cut it, but if it drops accidentally, then I'm in trouble. So
they got to do a couple repos here anyways and a bunch of rippers, so the buckers will be here anyway. They can get repoed or something. Okay, on to my next one. I can figure out where I'm going next. This one's got a heavy uphill lean. Big heavy uphill lean. But I think I can put it right in there. I think it'd be fine. It looks like a solid, healthy tree, so the holding wood should be good. So. Yeah, I gotta file up. I'll go find a stump in the shade or somewhere in the shade to file up after this tree.
Ah.
That was cool. That was cool. There's a big chunk way up there that got flung down the hill. See, that's why you make a high stop. Hold wood up. You probably take one log off of it, maybe. Yeah, everything's working out. Today's a good day. Everything's going as planned. No hiccups or getting pinched or brushing myself up or making a mess. Everything's going good. It's just this heat. It's supposed to be 35 degrees today, and it feels like it. Oh, there's not any wind. I need a drink. Watch out for some of those branches coming down. Right on. That was an easy one. In the shade too. So I can have a couple more in the shade. Right on. Oh man, is it hot out here in the sun. So I'm out here bucking this log here. I'm limbing it out, getting ready to buck it. And hearing the radio, another faller down the way thinks he sees smoke across the valley. And it's definitely got a blue tinge to it, so we're going to send the chopper up there to go take a look. I'll show you guys. There, you see that? Middle of the camera there? Has a blue tinge to it. It's coming right in the middle of the camera, behind that tree, way across the valley there. I'll try and find a better vantage point here. Hopefully it's not a fire. We might get shut down here. That's all right though. It's stinking hot. I'm gonna just take a little break.
Bye.
I just heard on the radio that it is smoke. The chopper went and did a recce. So it is smoke. I don't know what started the fire. Way out in the middle of nowhere on the side of the mountain. Pilot's gonna go put on his Billy. Is it called Billy Pew? Or bucket. Yeah, he's gonna put on his bucket and throw a couple drops of water on there until pickup time, which is hour and a half, just over hour and a half. Okay, what do I do? What do I got coming up next? I got that one. All these ones right here coming up next. And I got a real big one back there. Maybe I'll film that one, that real big one over there. Yeah, I'll film that one next. Well, looks like maybe it might've gone out or they suppressed it pretty good. I don't see any smoke anymore. Anyway, got this one here now. It's a real nice high grade piece. And I might have to wedge it. I want to put it right below that stump right there. Put it right in there. And then hopefully that it'll rest against that stump down there and roll down to there. I'm hoping, or it might just bounce up and over. So we'll see what happens here. Oh, that was an easy one. That turned out quite well.
Oh,
too much. I think I might cut far side off there. Yeah, we'll see.
Started to pinch me there. Yeah, the very, very tip there, I cut it off. The very last, this much I cut off. Well, the butt sort of stopped kind of where I wanted it, but the top kept going down. It's all right, it's still easy to buck, looks like. We have a bit of a breeze coming here now. Oh, it feels nice. Okay, so this will be the last one of the day, I figure. Time we get it down and bucked. Real nice one. Real nice. And I'm gonna put it. Try and put it right in here, just below this guy. Right. Yeah. Let's see. Probably, you see that little sapling right there? Right there, that little sapling. Right there in the center of the screen. Probably just to the left of it, right on the downhill side. Something like that, right in that area. It's a nice big one. I think I gotta flip my bar. I was gonna do it there the other day, but I didn't.
Good enough.
I'm on a roll. Lots of holding wood left. Yeah. I got laid up just perfectly for me to buck. Oh man, this is awesome. Yeah, having a good day. I'm gonna get one more tree in here. Yeah, we'll see. Oh man, it's stinking hot. Oh man, and the sun there is just way too hot. Luckily, I got some shade. All right, on. Okay, round two.
Savage line.
Oh, I don't like it doing this. It's not comfortable.
Did you go right in already?
No, I walked away.
So you haven't gone out completely in?
I
Why go in? You guys gotta go in.
I'd wanna go in, but I don't wanna be wet the whole ride out.
Yeah.
That's my only dilemma.
Oh man.
I guess I need a full set of clothes. You went in yesterday.
I know, and it sucked at first. It was fine
you
after.
You went all in a panic, just be like, you know it's not gonna kill you, just go in there.
I know, but it's very uncomfortable.
Yeah, hypothermia has never killed anyone. Heart attack?
I just, once I get numb enough, I'll be good.
You want me to splash you?
No!
I think it would help.
That would be the worst.
It would help you.
No,
it would
not.
Cold?
It's cold. Yeah, very cold. Somehow it seems colder than yesterday.
You jumping in from up there, Bruce?
No.
Big swan dive?
I think that's a little too brutal for my system.
Oh, it feels good. The bird bath feels good.
You know, at the rest area, there's a good little trick to jump there.
Okay, here we go.
Be good even with the kids.
Here we go.
It's freezing,
though. Yeah, at that point, I'd just keep driving. Taylor arm. Out of the Taylor River and get to the arm.
Yeah, but that's like a better beat.
Oh. Man. I'm gonna do it.
Woo!
So I think that's last trip. And then it's time to go home. Yeah, another nice day. What a beauty.